everyone, and welcome to Letty Does Runaways. So in the last episode, the group comes up with a plan to use their parents' pride gala to distract their parents while Alex and Nico go into Tina Minoru's office to acquire the video recordings of them doing their sacrificial rituals every year. So everything seems to be according to plan. Until they're giving their thank you speeches, and then Stein goes off track and reveals how Steven Minoru and his wife are sleeping together, and drama, 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 and then he falls down because he has He has a brain tumor, and he falls down, and everyone's panicking, but luckily, John is there, and he goes and injects Stein with some serum, shiny serum that looks, I guess, it's his blood. I have no idea what it's supposed to be, but he's magically all better and happy, and he thinks that his wife still loves him, and all this other crud. So that was incredibly strange. But the kids did manage to get the information that they needed from Alex somehow knowing Tina Minoru's password to her private personal office and not mentioning how, which is very suspicious. But in any case, they have all the videos of their parents committing all these crimes, and now they are ready to put them in jail. Except, Molly, in an attempt to learn more about her parents, has kind of spilled the beans to Alex's parents. They don't really know if everyone else in the group knows, but they at least know that Molly knows. So, definitely gonna be some drama from that. But I hope to see the effects of whatever shiny liquid that Stein was injected with to their full extent, and then to see what happens when either it wears off or it takes control. I don't know which one it would be, but shit's bound to go down because that stuff doesn't seem all that environmentally friendly. So, pretty much aside from that, I personally don't think they're gonna do anything with the information that they gathered from Tina Minoru's office in this episode, just because the drama is probably gonna, like, pile over the plot like it does every couple episodes, and I think that's what this episode is just gonna be. Marvel's Runaways, Season 1, Episode 7, Refraction. Let's get started. See? Told you! Gonna be more drama shit.
Someone could actually figure it out, though.
Oh gosh, is this the Steins meeting? Flirting? Is this flirting? Ugh, this is almost as bad as Gertrude's. So, cockroaches. What is this thing and how does it function?
Where were you?
Damn. Cold. This is not okay!
You don't know shit about—
Ooh.
I hope you got this in time.
His future looking machine is talking to him? He does know that this means that his machine works, right? Are they searching through Alex's room?
What are you doing in here?
No.
You guys were both collectively making fun of him.
And you did
different now. Okay?
This is definitely him coming down from whatever the hell it was that he was injected with, right?
You are right.
If I wanted to walk out, your
father
has given me more than enough excuses.
Cold.
Notice.
Well, I mean, it's not like he was able—
a long time trying to hold us all together.
It's not like he could tell either, so damn.
I'm not gonna let anything—
Watch, Nico. I hope you know that.
Drama, 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 drama. Drama, drama, drama.
And I know you love mom.
Yes?
Oh my god.
I wonder if this is like a given doctor, like if he knows what's going on or if he's just watching, like, the fuck?
Frank, stop it. Stop.
Okay, you weren't able to do that yesterday. What is your new job? So, Jonah wants to use him as a front for everything he's doing? Evening. The password. Yes! Good. It's kind of ironic, because Molly's probably the only one that didn't see everything. Molly, you know you're literally being stalked so that someone can kill you, right? Is leaving the group the best idea? Ah, yeah, so. That's not supposed to happen. What the hell, Jonah? Then it's gonna go down. So I guess in this universe, she isn't an alien like him. And they're setting Jonah out to be some big villain or something. Show her a little swing. So she wants to try out again? Is that what's happening?
All right, cut it. Do I know you?
Oh Molly. God, is this the same Molly, chick that tried to diss Carolina? Just leave it on the floor and walk away.
Hey,
and everything.
You don't. Really Why are you folding them if you still need to everything wash them?
Great. You know, I just wish everyone else felt the same.
Superpowered sisters.
To be achieved.
I have science to do.
What could be better?
Has he always had that lazy eye, or is that because of Jonah's thing?
That was the greatest. I mean, Crocs. What are Crocs? Crocs from God, don't you think?
That's wrong. You've been infected.
Infected with love.
You're tripping. I'm on Jonah.
What?
This is the best.
Who is it? We would love to, but we're deep into something
over here. Oh, this is
here.
Beautiful.
Are there things that you could be.
Leslie Jonah?
Mr. Dean?
Eighth are you... grade? Oh! What? That's creepy! Oh boy, how many times have you called his name and he didn't answer you? Of course something
Welcome
is wrong.
To Atlas.
Now for the past... Ooh, Robert came late! Oh, it looks like the club that Gertrude started actually continued without her.
All things are weird, but it'll feel more.
Why are people
soon.
So like, oh my gosh? Oh, the two of them have a little
always run
back and forth thing.
Ran them. I'm just.
Oh, she's gonna start crying again. I can't
angry.
Handle her crying. She just looks so sad when she cries. Together. No. She can't. There's a reason.
Sad. I was.
God. Way to make it awkward at the open house, guys.
Friends?
Hi.
Let him in. I want to hug that big bald teddy bear. I wonder if they know how much the Yorks like them.
What are the wise distractions?
Well, I mean, they were planning on killing her when they first suspected her. So they're planning on sending her off by herself to the Yucatan, or? Is that the lacrosse coach? I'll show you what I do to my son! Oh, there's the Victor sign we all know and love. Dude, what are they making him?
And why keep
is he a gibbon or?
No one loves the
fuck?
Church more than me, Leslie.
Well, everyone's marriages are just being strained. You've been Janet Stein. Before, you were just Janet Stein cheating with Stephen Minoru. Damn! Just like that. Oh my gosh, and Tina's right there. Because he's full of shit!
What's going on? Where? Why?
We just thought it would be
best. Oh, they are so sad.
For her. Kurt.
Damn. Look in his eyes for a moment. He was about to go full on Victor Stein.
We all saw. See, that's
Molly,
so
you're
wilder.
An idiot.
It's okay.
No, Molly, everyone getting murdered because of something you said is the worst.
And we're not gonna let anything.
Oh god, he came down from it, didn't he?
If you just...
Ooh! He dodged it!
Don't!
He said not to pick up the Fistagon! Well, technically, he only picked up one. Dude. Janet shot him with the gun that Robert gave her, didn't she? Fuck, she did! Oh man, it's a competition now. Which kid has the worst parents' marital issues? Ugh, it just ended. Alright, so it looks like I was correct in my assumption that this episode was just gonna be a bunch of drama and we weren't gonna get much plot progression. And, you know, we did get some. Mostly it was involving the whole affair thing, but Molly is going to be sent away, or at least they're gonna try to send her away, and now Victor Stein is dead, which is definitely going to piss off Jonah, especially now that they had just said, you know, everything's fine, it's all good now, and Victor Stein, dead. But that's Jonah's own fault, because Jonah knows what happens when someone comes down from his serum thing, because he used it like he knew what was gonna happen, so he could have expected this. But this episode was just really awkward. That entire thing with Robert and Tina Minoru after, like, Janet broke up with him and he's, like, crying and, oh, that was so awkward and awkward. But this probably did have my favorite scene, you know, aside from my fangirling from the comics, my favorite scene of just pure acting and comedy, which is definitely, what was his name? I forgot his name, but that's okay. Gertrude's father! That was amazing. I love that. It was really over the top and ridiculous, but god, it was hilarious to me. So, now that this show seems to be doing, like, plot drama, I expect there to be some plot in the next episode, most likely involving Jonah's origins, especially since we saw that creepy photo of, like, a full-grown man Jonah with, like, a younger middle school. Yeah, that was weird. Okay, so Frank now knows, I think. I don't even know what he knows. He's being Jonah's pawn or something, but shit's gonna go down. I don't even know exactly what's gonna happen, because I guess Jonah isn't just an alien anymore. He's potentially a gibbon that might destroy the world, and that's why he needed the sacrifices, and it's only him rather than, like, a couple of gibbons. I have no idea, honestly, what they're gonna do with this plot anymore. This is just, like, completely off the rail of whatever I was thinking, so let me know what you guys thought of this episode and what your thoughts are for the rest of the season, and I'll see you next time. Bye!
Hey everyone, it's me, Mario! I'm just spending some time in the Giant Kingdom with my lovely Princess Peach, but I'd like to tell you thank you so much for watching Letty's video. If you like what you saw, you can subscribe to Letty's channel by clicking that circle button up there, or you can watch more of Letty's videos over here, and you can find the latest news of Letty's Patreon by clicking that video down there.
Hey, I've come to claim Princess Peach!
Hey, who the hell is this guy?
cry.
Oh no! Mamma mia!